Do you remember that you took a note about this study in the sample info tab? This experiment inactivated AIR alpha with CERNA. If you Google it, you find the name of the gene as ESRRA. You back to Subio platform software and search ESRRA in the annotations tab. You see that the expression level of the gene is suppressed less than 1/5 by all the three types of CERNAs. You also see the names of the other 15 genes, but maybe you don't know about all of them. So, it is helpful to make the data with the annotation of all genes to interpret in the biological context. You get gene2go and gene_info files from NCBI's FTP site. Open the Data Manager tab, open the Edit Platform panel, and open the Lookup Tool panel. You use gene symbols as the matching key to import other annotations. Open the Lookup tool again. You use Gene ID as the matching key to import gene ontology information from the gene2go file. Make sure you use the Concatenate All Values option this time. You can access to the imported gene annotation from the Annotations tab. You can choose columns to show in table arbitrarily. As you saw in the DEG analysis part, commonly down-regulated genes are significantly few comparing to the commonly up list. Let's collect genes related to estrogen and save the list. Open the Venn diagram tool to compare the estrogen-related genes and the commonly up or down lists. ESRRA is only one gene that is in the intersection of estrogen-related and commonly down lists. On the other hand, there are 5 genes in the intersection of estrogen-related and commonly up lists. Because the commonly up genes are remarkably more than down, the up genes are likely to associate with some biological functions or pathways. The enrichment analysis tool in the advanced plugins package is useful to search enriched biological features. Please learn more about the enrichment analysis in the dedicated tutorial. You can filter the result by keywords like estrogen or signaling. And you can trace what genes they are actually.